let's just remind ourselves we're in amongst the Olympic Park here, and the Olympic motto is faster, higher, stronger. Well, if there was a motto for Formula One teams, it would be much simpler. It would be make it fast, make it faster, and make it fastest. And as we see the winner's trophy there, proudly displayed in what looks like a no man's land between the head of the grid, where am I? And I think that's the Cuban Cossack dancers over there. So actually, let me just get a quick line from Paul Hembree. Paul, you've got a whole bunch of happier Formula One drivers this year. You were asked to come up with grippier tyres, lower degradation, you've delivered. You must be quite a happy man.
So far, so good, as you know, early stage of the season, but they seem to be happier. But it's a competitive world and everyone's still looking for every margin. You probably heard Lewis, you know, struggling a little bit yesterday. You could see from the images that they weren't quite getting the package working perfectly. But overall, yeah, they seem to be happier.
And it's Ultras, it was the tyre of choice in quali. They'll go to the Super Softs with their one change and run it to the end. One stop, probably.
Yeah, one stop, probably getting around to 20, 25 laps, making the change. But safety car might change that, but otherwise, relatively straightforward.
Okay, great. Have a safe race. Right. Let's see if we can find any peddlers. The Ferrari boys are out of the cars, but don't traditionally say anything. But Ross Brawn there, surveying all that he now kind of owns. We've got Jock Clear and Niki Lauda. Now, Jock isn't allowed to speak at the moment as a Ferrari representative, but Niki Lauda is. So, on one hand, you like competition. On the other hand, you must be, you know, they're faster than us by a margin.
I like competition, but I'm frustrated. Because if Ferrari keeps on going like they did in the last race, it's going to be difficult for Lewis or Bottas. But let's wait and see. A race can change a lot of things.
It can, and you have a lot of experience of overcoming all sorts of adversity in your own career. Are you feeling a bit more like a father figure to some of these young guns at Mercedes who've only seen success the last few years? This is something new for them.
It's new for us because we had a margin, and the margin is easier. Now it's no margin, the others are quicker. So now we have to work hard to catch up, very simple.
Okay. Well, we wish you luck with that. We've got your young charger there, Valtteri Bottas, making his way. Good luck, Niki. Valtteri looked like he was about to speak to German TV. So let's move our way down the grid. Lewis Hamilton, not only out of position in his normal qualifying, but he's on the dirty side of the grid as well, which is going to be interesting. That is an opportunity. Christian Horner here. Lewis, out of sorts in qualifying, on the dirty side of the grid.
Yeah.
It's a long way to turn two, yeah. Which isn't, you know, turn one doesn't really count here. Is that an opportunity for Daniel, or you just don't have enough straight line speed?
Well, we're hoping for a good tow, a good suck off Bottas down to turn two, and that could give Daniel a chance, maybe make a bit of ground at the first couple of corners, because that's going to be the real key point of the race.
Yeah, okay. And other talking points, this is not really a good circuit for you with all these straights, is it?
It's not our best. I mean, we're fighting a water leak on Max's car. Hopefully that's under control. So, you know, we'll be keeping our fingers crossed on that one.
Okay, well, have a great race. Thank you very much. Right, we have Daniel Ricciardo's car. I don't see Daniel there. Let's see if we keep walking down. We've got, actually, I do see a Daniel. I'll just grab a walk and talk here with Daniel. Right, Daniel, you were reasonably happy, if I can put it like that, with your qualifying position, in that you weren't really able to do much more. But what's your mindset going into a race like this today?
We know that the guys in front of us are obviously very quick, but you still approach it with an attacking mindset. You know, things happen in races, and nothing's impossible. So sure, I'll be looking ahead. But I guess once the race settles down, it might stabilise a bit.
Have you got a quick question for Stoffel?
How are you?
Good.
Oh, good, right. Well, Stoffel, your car difficult right at the back, but you just need to go for it, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, we've got nothing to lose, really. It's all about the learning. So, the only way is up for us.
Good stuff. Right, so we're getting to the pinch point now. You can see it's pretty busy down the front of the grid. Got a minute to go. Get Lewis Hamilton with his brolly up, trying to keep as cool as possible. I think most of the drivers will have made their way to the front. What we're going to be treated to is the national anthem being sung by the Cuban Cossack Choir. And of course, you'll all know that they are one of the leading folkloric ensembles in Russia. Their repertoire and performances reflect the songs "Too Early, Ian, Go Away." They reflect the songs, dances, folklore of the Cuban Cossacks. Well, I'm a big fan. I hope you are. We're set up for a cracking race here between Ferrari and Mercedes. I'm going to trot off to the commentary box. Let's see if Ferrari trot off into the distance for this race. Enjoy.